It's so nice to be playing this game online again, because it has been a little while since I last touched Formula One 2020 on the Xbox One, but here we are. And I figured, well, because of the recent news with Williams and that awful time penalty that I'm going to distract you from, I thought I'd just drive the Williams, because the Williams livery this year is pretty great. Although, now that I think about it, I don't know if the Rocket livery was better or this one, but I'm kind of more inclined to go for this one just because it's more simplistic and just cleaner looking. And I really like the Williams logo anyway, so, or the type font anyway. So here is my first online race in, I think about 2 months, I think. And it's on probably one of the most driver-friendly tracks on the calendar, actually. Well, in terms of the game anyway, because the game, with regards to this track particularly, the game's really just easy. It's just easy to drive on. I remember when I originally played on this track back in F1 2018, I thought this track would be a bit of a pain in the ass, a bit of a doozy, but it's just easy. You can just kind of switch off your mind almost. It's really kind of boring, although entertaining to get right anyway. Like, the actual F1 races are kind of boring, go figure, I guess. But so yeah, and this is with the strict track limits, which I'm not a huge fan of, because I think some tracks do it worse than others. This is actually an alright example, but I slowly got my act together with it, and I like to think that I actually did really well, because there'd be a couple of races when I last tried this where I'd get outright disqualified from penalties. And since then, I've gone, well, okay, I need to learn my track limits better, clearly. So if people do want to race leagues on strict track limits, then I can at least, you know, get around that to a degree and drive a bit smoother. And I feel like, in a way, it's encouraging me to be a little bit quicker too and be more strategic with the lines I take. As you can see here, compared to, say, last year, or, you know, this time last year I was playing F1 2019, mind you, but when I was doing a league early this year in F1 2019, my lines through here would have been completely different, to some degree anyway. Some turns would be really similar, but they did change the profiling on like this turn in particular. This turn feels slower than it does in 2019. I was actually watching some F1 2019 footage earlier, and you do feel the difference. These cars are more oversteery. I was finally able to put it to words, actually, because I was chatting to the person who was running the server, and him and I were both chatting about it, and he said, yeah, the cars are definitely more oversteery. And I actually personally really like oversteery cars, which, I mean, I guess it makes sense, because these things are almost mid-engined. Would they be considered mid-engined? I think they're considered rear-engined, but the engine's pretty close to being placed in the middle, to be fair. So I guess it's not surprising to have some oversteer characteristics in the cars, but setup in this game is definitely very important. As I had previously stated, it's a shame I couldn't show you more of this F1 race, to be honest, because I started P13, I think one guy retired, so it was 15 cars and one left, but I started like P14 or 13, depending if I'm wrong or not, I actually can't remember, but anyway, and managed to basically just blitz my way up into P3, which was really satisfying. This was such a fun race to do again. And it prompted me to just do a video on this game, because it's been quite a while since I last did any videos. And not many people are probably wondering why. But I've just been just enjoying life. I don't need to be doing this every day. It's fun to do the videos occasionally, don't get me wrong. But I've just been enjoying the games lately and not being inundated with the feeling of pressure to do any content recently. And I think that's a good thing, really. Although I really needed to get my music project together, but it'll get there. So yeah, this is another really inconsistent, incoherent video. We've gotten to this point in the video. Thanks for watching. I do plan on doing more F1 2020 videos, among other games. There is actually a backlog of videos I need to cut through. So yeah, if you've gotten to this point in the video, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it to some degree. Like and subscribe and do whatever. And yeah, see you in the next video.